Hi, makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers. Harley here with another episode here at the House of Hacks. Last episode, I showed you how to make some soft jaws for vise so that you could clamp things without using the metal jaws on the vise to mar things up. This kind of gives you a nicer, a little bit more resilient surface so that you don't, if you have projects you need to fit that are already finished that you need to put in the vise, they won't get marred by the metal jaws. So that's kind of the purpose of these. Last episode I just cut it out and we had just a couple pieces of wood that fit in the vise. This episode I'll go through and we'll do some improvements to these, clean them up a bit, and kind of finish them off as a project. So if you didn't get to see last episode, you can click here and go take a look at it. At the end of that episode, we had, like I said, two pieces of wood that just fit in the jaws here, and you can clamp, put something in here, and they'll stay in place for you for the most part while you can kind of clamp something in here and just like so. So this episode, one of the problems with this is they do stay in here. But they could, you know, they're a little bit flimsy. They don't like staying in there really well. It's better than just pieces of wood that you have to hold in place. But the first thing that I want to do is add some magnets to this so they'll stay in place very solidly. So in order to do that, we'll first of all go over to the drill press and drill some holes for the magnets. So I was accompanying my wife to the on some errands the other day, and she had to go by the office store, and I found these in the section where they have rubber bands and staples and paper clips and so forth. A couple packet of magnets. There's 12 of them in this pack, 3/4 inches around, and I don't know how thick, but as I was looking at them, it looked like they were probably going to fit perfect for this project. And when I got home, I found, in fact, they fit really, really well. They're thin enough that they're thinner than the wood. And so what I'm going to do is bore a hole in the wood. I've got four marks put in here, all at the same place. So they should all line up fairly well. I've set the depth gauge on the drill press so it won't go all the way through. And because we want the magnets to go below the plane, this plane, so they're not kind of causing it to rock on the vises. So I think we're ready to drill these out. Okay, I had a slight failure on the last, when I set the depth gauge. As you can see, maybe from this angle, these two pieces of wood are a little bit different in thickness. And I set the depth gauge for this piece, so when I drilled out the holes on this one, they of course were shallower by the difference of the thicknesses of the wood. So the maggots fit perfect in this one. They're a little bit proud of the plane on this one, so I just reset the depth gauge, and I'm going to take another pass at these to kind of make them a little bit deeper. okay, so I'm ready to put the magnets in, and I'm going to just 5-minute epoxy them in so they'll stay in and they'll never be coming out. One thing before I epoxy them in, though, I've got 4 magnets here, and I've got them set up so that these two connect together nicely, and these two connect together, and then I also have it set up so they go corner to corner and connect up. And I'll show you why I did that later in the episode. It'll become clear, but I'm going to just mark all of these with a mark so I can, and I'll put the mark down when I glue them in, and that way they'll all be with the orientation that I want them to be in. Okay, the epoxy's dried now, and we're almost ready for the next step. Wanted to show you why I had the magnets arranged the way I did. It's so that, number one, when the jaws are in the vise, the magnets are repulsing each other, and so they won't stick to each other when they get close. They'll always be pushing away from each other to the other jaw. That's number one. Number two, for storage purposes, they clip together like that for nice compact means of storage. So that's it for upgrade number one. Upgrade number two, I'm going to drill a hole in here for hanging. We'll go over to the drill press, and it's just a simple hole. Okay, I'm over here at the drill press. I've got a 1/4-inch drill bit in here. That should be large enough for most nail heads. And also, if I want to put it on a pegboard, it'll be large enough for the standard size little hooks that they have for those. And I put a little mark here halfway between this edge and this edge, and just halfway between where the edge of the magnet is and the edge here. I'm going to come back just a hair so it's a little bit closer to the magnet to give me a little bit more wood on the top edge here. So we should be good to go here. Just like so. Beauty. Now that I have the magnets in and the holes drilled for hanging it, the next step is I'm going to put some paint on it, try to dress it up a little bit, make it look nicer. I'm not all that great at finish work, and so I'm going to spend a little bit of time on it, just more out of practice than anything else. Sand it a little bit with increasing grades of sandpaper to give a nice smooth finish. Some wood sealer to seal the wood before I put the top coat on it red. So that's kind of what I'm going to do next, the next quote-unquote upgrade. Okay, that finishes the first pass of sanding. Now I'm going to use some tack cloth here and wipe it down a little bit. Get all the dust off of it from sanding. You know, I realize I'm probably going way overboard for what I need on this little shop tool thing that nobody's ever going to see. But, you know, I'm of the philosophy that always do the best you can. And small things like this just work as practice for when your skills are really needed. Okay, the next thing is to put on some of this wood sealer. Okay, gonna let that sit overnight and let it dry. I've got 3 coats of sealer now on the soft jaws, and I sanded with 320 grit in between each coat just to kind of try to smooth everything out. I think I'm ready to now put the color coat on it. So I'll do one more final sanding with the 320 just real lightly to cut the sheen in any high spots, and then I'll paint it red. I just put a final sand on it and wiped it down with tack cloth, and I just created this little painting booth. This is the first time I've ever done anything like this. Kind of see how it works out. I hung it on some wire. I think you can see it hanging here. and I put a hole in the top of the box, and the idea is as I paint, I can turn it to be able to give it a get on the back side of it. Well, we'll see how it turns out. The makeshift painting booth idea worked really well. The box contained the overspray, and the rotating wires worked to get on both sides of the object. So overall, I was really pleased with it. I did have two issues. First was the box is a little bit on the small side, and getting paint up underneath on the bottom was a bit tricky. The second thing was when I first started, I had my two objects, the wire was bent a little bit closer than it is now, and the object, the magnets, would sway together and cause them to click together, kind of like that. And I had to pull it apart with the wet paint on there and clean things up, and it was really messy. I ended up spreading the wires apart a little bit and didn't have the problem anymore. Overall, I would say it was a success and worked well. So the last thing I want to do to these soft jaws is put a silicone surface on it, kind of give it a rubberized jaws on it, keep the paint from transferring to objects that it's holding, and also give it just a little bit more soft jawness, I guess. So I ran into this product a couple months ago called Subaru. It's available online, and I've used it for a couple projects. It's really cool stuff. It's a room temperature curing silicone paste, putty. So it's kind of like Play-Doh from kindergarten, and it comes in these sealed packets and in multiple colors. This particular package has five colors in it: orange, blue, green, black, and white. And I think I've used up all the black on other projects. So it comes in these little tiny packets, and they're color-coded, and there's a little instruction, 7 steps to becoming a Subaru guru. And so, like, here's some green, and I think we'll use green for, actually this is black, I think. We'll use black for these jaws. And I think I have another one in here. White, orange, there we go. So I don't know if I'm gonna need one or two packets. So I'll open one and give that a try. And the biggest downside to this stuff is it does have an expiry date. And this says used by August, and it's now a couple months after August. It still feels like it's okay to use. My guess is they're probably a little conservative on the dates. So we'll open this up and hopefully it will be good. We'll just cut this open, and there's just a little, yeah, it still looks pretty good. And you just kind of manipulate it with your fingers a little bit. It's a little bit on the dry side, but I think it'll still be pliable enough to work. You just kind of manipulate it a little bit to get it working well. And in this case, I'm going to just kind of roll this out. It looks like I'm going to need two containers for this particular project, one for each soft jaw. So I'm going to just kind of put this on here, like so. And you can use all kinds of different implements to form it the way you want it, texture it the way you want it. I'm going to use an old ribbon cable for old hard drive, and just to kind of give it some lines, texture in it, and we'll see how that kind of works out. Try to get it fairly level and flat, and peel this off, and so that's kind of what it looks like. It's not a perfect job, but we can kind of push this back a little bit, square it up some, like that, and so now we'll just let that sit, and I'll do the next one with another one, and we'll let it sit, let it cure, and come back to it in a little bit. So I think that's about it for this project. The sugar is about to cure. It's been about 10 hours, and the packaging says it's 3 millimeters for 24 hours. And it could probably go overnight and be a little bit better, but it feels like it's pretty solid now. So I really like this sugar. I've used it on a couple projects now, and it comes out really cool. It is past its lifetime, though. This was definitely drier and not as pliable to work with as it was for the last couple projects I worked on that were before the expiry date. So that's really the biggest disadvantage, particularly for me. You have to order it online, and so you either have to have some on hand and risk it going bad on you before you use it all up, or you don't have it on hand and you don't have it when you need it. So it's kind of a good news, bad news situation in that regard. I haven't quite figured out what I'm going to do with this long term as a product and using it in my hacks and stuff. So I think that pretty much wraps up this project. It's nice and red and painted, and I now have a clean spot. I have to redo my vise, get it repainted. It has a little hole to hang things up, and it looks nice. It has the silicone to buffer, to give it a little padding. And yeah, I'm pretty pleased with the way that turned out. So until next time, go make something. It doesn't have to be perfect, just have fun.